Planting is at
a place full of fruit.
A horn that goes. A painting is at.
At. A sculpture is at.
It's made out of clay or paper mache. A sculpture is at.
My sweet buttercups, how are you doing today? It has been so wonderful to spend February with you, and now it's almost over. Can you believe that in 3 days we are going to start the month of March? And guess what? It will be springtime soon. The trees will turn green and there will be flowers blooming everywhere. Oh, I can now imagine the colors outside. This is the best time to paint outdoors. I really wish and pray that we can spend springtime going outside, running around with our friends and family.
Here are some of Claude Monet's outdoor paintings coming to life.
Last Tuesday, we learned about a new artist named Claude Monet. We discovered that he was a French artist who was an impressionist painter. An impressionist is someone who captures the changing light and colors in his painting.
Even ordinary things like a wheat stack. Or an ocean. Or a rocky cliff. Or a boat on the water. This is a painting I entered in our show. It's called Impression Sunrise. It's where the name Impressionist came from. A newspaper man who saw the painting called the whole group of us Impressionists.
His paintings didn't look very real, but they were absolutely beautiful. Did you guys know that he painted about 1,000 paintings and they now sell for millions of dollars? Let's continue to review about Claude Monet.
All about Monet. This is Claude Monet. He is from France. Monet is a famous painter. When he was a boy, he didn't like school very much, but he loved to draw. He was very good at drawing, and people would buy his cartoons. When Monet became older, he went to Paris to study art. He made many friends with other artists. At the time, a lot of paintings were very serious and used serious colors. Monet and his friends broke the rules and painted with bright colors and fast, exciting lines. Other artists only painted important people, but Monet and his friends wanted to capture a feeling or a moment. Like when the sun sets, or when a ballerina turns, or when steam puffs out of a train. Monet and his friends loved to paint outside, while other artists only painted inside in a studio. People started calling them the Impressionists. Their style is called Impressionism. Monet made all kinds of paintings, but his favorite paintings were of nature. Monet had a big family and lived in a pink and green house. That is where he painted his water lily paintings. Many artists have been inspired by Monet's work. You can find Monet's paintings in museums all around the world.
When Monet was older, he worked on the biggest project of his lifetime. He made huge paintings on the pond at his home. He did paintings of mornings, sunsets, clouds, and water lilies. He spent the last 10 years of his life working on them, and then he donated them to the country of France.
Many years after the first Impressionist show, I had sold enough paintings to settle down and buy a house in the beautiful French town of Giverny. I built a wonderful water garden there. I spent years painting scenes of my garden. These paintings of water lilies from my garden are some of the most beautiful and famous ones I did. Some of them are over 40 feet wide. That's me when I was an old man in front of one of my famous paintings. I lived to be 86 years old, by the way. My brushstrokes became drier and looser near the end of my life. Close up, these paintings really look abstract. I wonder if I influenced any of those modern artists who came after me. I was able to show how things looked at the moment I saw them, almost like a camera does. I loved nature and painted with colors so a scene would look as much like nature as possible. I was even able to paint mist and fog and make it seem real. Today, my paintings are in museums all over the world. I hope you get a chance to see some of them in person. When you get real close, you can see how simple my brushstrokes are and how many colors I used. Maybe you can try doing a painting in my style. It will help you understand Impressionism a little better. And who knows? You might even be a future world's great artist someday. Well, goodbye for now. It was nice getting to know you.
Today, we are going to paint water lilies just like Claude Monet. We are going to try to capture the changing light and colors of the day. Are you ready to do this with me? Then let's begin.
It's art time.
For the water lily painting, you're going to need the water lily worksheet and the water lily leaves printed on cardstock, some acrylic paint in pastel colors. That means you're going to add white on your secondary and primary colors, a paintbrush, scissors, and some masking tape. The first thing that you need to do is to paint the water lily leaves and the water lilies using some acrylic paint. Make sure that you use pastel colors because that is what Monet used. You also will do some short strokes just like this on your painting. Now that I have painted all of the leaves, it's time to paint the water. Using short strokes with blue mixed with white acrylic paint, I'm going to paint the water around the leaves. Now that I've painted all the leaves and the water, it's time to paint the water lilies. There are 1, 2, 3, and 4 water lilies. I'm thinking of painting them pink and purple. You can use whatever color you want. I painted one flower pink and one flower purple. Now it's time to paint the middle part yellow. Once you've painted both pages, you're going to wait for them to dry. Now that the paint is dry, it's time to cut the flowers. Now that we're done cutting the flowers, we are going to curl the tips of the petal just like that. And we will do the same thing with the other flower. Now that we have all the petals curled in, it's time to stick our water lilies on the pond. Wonderful time learning about different artists with you guys. You are all gifted artists. You made me so happy with all of your artwork. I can't wait for the next ones. When I see you in March, we will be learning more about this famous artist. I'll see you next time. Bye for now.